हरिओम। वी स्टार्टेड विथ अर्जुनास कन्फ्यूजन इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर एंड देन स्लोली स्टेप बाय स्टेप भगवान कृष्ण इज रिमूविंग ऑल द कन्फ्यूजन्स फ्रॉम हिज माइंड फ्रॉम हिज इंटेलेक्ट। द मेन टीचिंग ऑफ दिस भगवद्गीता इज अबाउट अवर ओन सेल्फ। भगवद्गीता इज लाइक अ मिरर विच शोज अस अवर ओन सेल्फ बिकॉज एवरीथिंग बॉइल्स डाउन to finally knowing ourselves. In Bhagwan 10th chapter also he says, Adhyatma Vidya Vidyanam. Out of all knowledge of this world, great knowledge are there in this world, but the only knowledge which will liberate us is the knowledge of our own self. We have to recognize ourselves as we are, which might appear very strange because we are with ourselves all the time, but still we have not comprehended our own self properly. It's a big mystery, it's a big illusion sort of, and we are not aware of our real nature. So that is the main theme of not only Bhagavad Gita, but all our scriptures, that finally it leads us to this goal of enlightenment. And as we move towards it, we will feel more and more peaceful, more and more happy. Also, the surrounding also will become more conducive for us. So even from the worldly standpoint, it is beneficial, it is profitable to be spiritual. Generally people feel spiritual, it might not be profitable. It is better to become something in this world. But really speaking, as we progress towards our own self, in the sense as we progress towards the state of enlightenment, we will feel more peaceful, more happy, one will become more efficient, and it will be beneficial from the worldly standpoint also. It will improve all our relationship, and everything will be nice. So therefore, there might be many, many problems, but the solution is one for all those problems. Know thyself. Recognize yourself as you are. And in order to recognize ourselves, the final step, the final doorway is to meditate on our own self, on the sense of I which we have. That is the gateway to come to comprehend ourself. Oh, वहाँ पर आवाज करता है मलाइदास, you just see that it's so one should go away from all noise to that supreme peace in our own self. For that, the path is dhyana. Dhyana avastita tadgatena manasa pashyantiyam yoginaha. When a person goes, when our mind goes in the state of meditation, one comes to see ourselves as we are. Practicing meditation is not meditation. Agitation is not meditation. Concentration is not meditation. When we reach that state of meditation, one will be able to see oneself as we are. We only experience three states, the waking, the dream, and the deep sleep state. We have not experienced the state of meditation. When we experience the state of meditation, we become free of all our confusion, all our bondage. So dhyana is the final step which one has to take in order to recognize oneself. When everything is ready, it's like we click the photograph. In the good old days, those cameras, manual camera, we have to focus, we have to select the aperture, we have to select the speed, the filters and the thing, so many things. And then finally, we ask the subject to smile. If it is object, it cannot smile, but we smile. And then we click. And when we click, that is the final click. At that moment, whatever is there will come. Similarly, meditation is the final click. Before that, lot of preparation goes to prepare our mind for meditation, to prepare the intellect for meditation. So the intellect is prepared for meditation when it has got sound understanding. When there is no confusion in the intellect regarding the nature of the self, regarding the nature of this world, through the help of the scriptures, through the help of the words of a great realized masters, the intellect is convinced, all its questions are answered. So intellect keeps quiet. Otherwise, the intellect will keep on asking questions. And if the intellect is asking question, you cannot meditate. It's like someone is sitting for meditation and the child is constantly asking or moving or shaking you, you won't be able to meditate. Similarly, if the intellect has got lot of doubts, lot of questions, confusions, then meditation is difficult, it's not possible. So we have to make, through the study of the scriptures, the doubts of the intellect is quieted. Through following certain sadhana, certain spiritual practices, we have to also purify our mind, make it more and more pure. And once the mind, the intellect, are tuned, then we can sit, meditate, and recognize our own self. In order to tune our mind and intellect and prepare it for meditation, Bhagwan has given lots of sadhanas here, starting from karma yoga, bhakti, jnana marga, so many things he explained to Arjuna. In the beginning, he talked to him about karma yoga, that you perform your duties, fulfill your responsibilities, dedicating all this to the Supreme, to God. Then Bhagwan also taught to Arjuna the various upasanas which will help us to further purify our mind. From the standpoint of Ishvara, he explained how this whole world is, that it is my prakriti only, para prakriti, apara prakriti, and how the whole play of this world is just a play of this prakriti, para and apara. And finally, in this 13th chapter, which we saw last month, Bhagwan showed us the ultimate identity of this self, the inner, the self, the I, with that supreme reality. That the supreme reality alone expresses as our self in this particular body. So in order to search for God, we have to go within this our own body, our own heart, and recognize that God within. In the 13th chapter, Bhagavan conveyed to Arjuna that this body is Kshetra, and the one who is aware of this body, one who is conscious of the body, Kshetrajna, but the Kshetrajna is really that supreme truth alone. I had given the example of the moon and the light shining on the moon. So when that moon is there, the light is shining. So together, because of the light and that object, we see that moon. But that light itself cannot be comprehended, cannot be seen. But if there are, suppose, 10 moons, then all those 10 moons will be illumined by the same light. Similarly, all of us, all our bodies are like moon, and that light which is illumining our body is that consciousness which is aware of this body, our own body, is that light of that supreme truth, supreme self alone. So we have to understand that I, the consciousness in me, itself is that supreme reality, supreme truth. So in order to make it comprehensible, Bhagavan explained in detail in the previous chapter using the term Kshetra and Kshetrajna. Also, he mentioned so many values which will help us to further comprehend, as Jnanam, Amanitvam, Adambhitvam and all. And later on, he said that through Dhyana, you will be able to recognize me. If Dhyana is difficult for you, do some study. Make it clear in your mind, remove your doubts, and then you meditate. If still the doubts are not going, then follow the path of Karma Yoga, purify your mind, then study the scriptures, remove your doubts, then meditate and recognize yourself. And what is meditation? Meditation is just focusing your attention on that I, the self. Atma, when we say Atma, we have funny idea about Atma. So I am not using the word Atma. That day I was telling someone Atma and thought that it is some sort of ghost. So because that word Atma is so common, we use it for everything now. So another word for that same Atma is I. I, though it is used commonly and at least hundreds of times we must be using during the day, but still it is not contaminated. I, pure I am so and so gets contaminated. But when you just come to that I, it is not contaminated. When you just say I and focus your attention on it, you will find that it has got no gender also. That pure I, it has got no gender. When we say I am a man, I am a woman with respect to body, then the gender comes. Otherwise, in that pure I, there is no gender. That I is God within. That I, which we experience, is the witness of this body, witness of my mind, and is the experiencer, the subject behind all my experiences. So that I is called also Purusha. And that body and all is called Prakriti. And when that I, in its pure state, when we recognize that I is also called Purushottama, the Supreme Person. So this Purusha, when it gets attached to Prakriti, then the whole game of samsara begins. When I am identified with my body, mind, intellect, then samsara begins. when I separate myself from this body, mind, intellect and recognize my pure nature, I become free of samsara. So this I is in between. So let us say this is I. And this is the body. So when I gets attached to the body, samsara begins. When I is separated and understands its real nature, we become free of samsara. And in order to do this, we have to focus our attention on this I. Our attention, though we are using hundreds of times the word I, our attention is not on I. It is on what I see, what I hear, what I taste, what I smell, what I think, what I feel. It is on everything other than I. So we have to focus our attention on this I. Now the question is that how does this I get caught up in this Prakriti? Bhagwan had mentioned in the previous chapter that Purusha Prakriti Sthohi Bhungte Prakriti.